We were right at the edge of the airfield, and we had been told that our job was to cross the airfield and attack the pillboxes. We knew that much.
And then we went into a nonstop four-day, four-night battle.
A bomb detonated in my feet, and I lived, and four individuals that were 30 feet away died from that bomber.
And not just Medal of Honor recipients, but anybody who spent any time in combat will tell you the same thing. Whatever I did at least partially, because if the situation were reversed, my buddies would do it for me.
And so I spent a lot of time in the hospital, 5 months, 4 months inpatient, which was really frustrating. You know, 4-hour vitals, every 4-hour vitals, you never sleep. And I was going through some really tough times emotionally as well and mentally from, you know, the incident.
From position to position, treating the wounded, redistributing ammunition. And at the end of the fourth night, we was completely nothing left.
When they finished reading the citation, that's when the president puts the ribbon around your neck with the medal. At that point, my body was shaking so bad, I could not be still. I mean, I was absolutely scared to death. I never thought I'd ever see a president, let alone, you know, stand face to face with him.
Hey, just because you receive this medal doesn't mean that your mission's over. Like, this is just, you're a courier of it. And I use the word courier now, always. And you have a platform to do an incredible amount of good. And I know you, I trust in you that you will be an outstanding representative.
That I don't wear it for myself. I wear it for all those who can. And I represent everybody in uniform. Think about all the people who fought in combat in the last 245 years in this country and who performed valiantly on the battlefield, and nobody saw it.
Are doing things because we care for something else more than ourselves. We're not doing it for any kind of glory or any kind of recognition for ourselves.
The testimony of my commanding officer and the other Marines are the reason I have the Medal of Honor. Had they not been willing to make that recommendation, and those Marines not been willing to testify as to what took place that day, I would not be privileged to wear this medal around my neck.
Mostly I was a soldier, and the place for me was where we were fighting, and that's why I went to Vietnam principal.